Hey everybody, Chris here from O'Reilly Auto Parts to show you how to change the radiator hose on a Chevy 5.3 liter V8 engine. Before I get into that, take a second to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already so you don't miss out on any of our new content. Today I'll be installing a radiator hose on this 2003 Chevy Avalanche 1500, but the process will be similar on a lot of Chevy Vortec V8s. A good number of GM and Chevy trucks were equipped with this engine, but be sure to know the specifics for your truck before getting started. And if you're not completely comfortable doing this yourself, we'd be happy to recommend a professional technician in your area. Once you've got your supplies together, here's what you'll do. Start by parking on a level surface, letting the vehicle cool, and disconnecting the negative battery cable. Slowly rotate the surge tank fill cap counterclockwise. Stop rotating and allow the hissing to stop. After all hissing stops, continue turning counterclockwise to remove the cap. Put a drain pan in place and open the petcock. Allow the system to drain completely. Close the radiator petcock. Take off the engine cover by loosening the intake manifold sight shield bolt. Remove the cover from the cover retainer, then remove the cover retainer bolts and the retainer if required. Loosen the air cleaner outlet duct clamps at the throttle body and mass airflow intake air temperature sensor. Remove the radiator inlet hose clip from the outlet duct, then remove the air cleaner outlet duct. Detach the radiator vent inlet hose from the radiator hose clips. If equipped, remove the throttle body heater hose retainer and the inlet radiator hose retainer from the fan shroud. Loosen the inlet hose clamp and remove the inlet hose from the radiator. Detach the inlet hose clamp from the water outlet. Remove the inlet hose clip from the fan shroud. And remove the hose. Remove the clamps to disconnect the lower radiator hose from the water pump inlet and radiator outlet. Now is a good time to transfer the clamps from your old radiator hose to your new one. Secure the new upper hose to the water outlet using the hose clamp. Install the inlet hose clip to the fan shroud. Use the hose clamp to attach the hose to the radiator. And attach the radiator vent inlet hose with the radiator inlet hose clips. Secure the new lower radiator hose at the water pump inlet. And radiator outlet using the hose clamps. Install the air cleaner outlet duct. Be sure the arrow at the throttle body end of the duct is in alignment with the throttle body attaching stud. Install the radiator inlet hose clips to the outlet duct. Tighten the air cleaner outlet duct clamps at the throttle body and the MAF IAT sensor to 62 inch pounds. Install the engine cover by putting it in place and securing it with the retainer and bolts if required. Tighten the bolts to 44 inch pounds. Refill the cooling system and replace the cap. Be sure to follow your vehicle manufacturer's specifications for coolant type, ratio, and fill procedure. Reconnect your negative battery cable. Remove your drain pan, start your vehicle, and let it warm up to operating temperature with the heater on. If the heater is blowing warm air, turn the truck off, check the coolant level, and add coolant as needed, then close the hood. And that's it. You'll find everything that you need for this and other jobs at your local O'Reilly Auto Parts store or O'ReillyAuto.com. Our DIY videos are designed to help answer questions we get in our stores every day. If you found this one helpful, subscribe to our channel to get all the latest. We'll see you again soon.